So let's see the example of turnbuckle. So the question is, the pull in the tie rod of an iron rope truss is 50 kN. Design a suitable turnbuckle, that is adjustable screw joint. The permissible stresses are 75 MPa in tension, 37.5 MPa in shear, and 90 MPa in crushing. So before solving the example, you need to know the design procedure of turnbuckle. So in notes, you have given the design procedure of turnbuckle. So you have to remember one thing here, that is for threaded portion, the design load is taken. So that design, the value of design load, which is denoted by PD, is 30 times more than the given load to account for the friction in threads. So always keep in mind that in example you have given the actual load. So for calculations, you need to consider the design load, so which is calculated by using PD is equal to 1.5 times P. So it will become 65 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Okay. So before starting with the actual solution, you have to convert all the units into actual SI units. So force is given in kilonewton, convert it into Newton, and all the values of stresses are given in megapascal. As we know, 1 megapascal is equal to 1 Newton per mm square. So we do not need any conversion for the stresses. Okay, let's see the first step. So first step is diameter of the rod, tie rod. So the equation for diameter of tie rod is sigma t is equal to PD upon pi by 4 dc square. So here this dc is nothing but core diameter of the bolt, as we are considering the threaded portion for the coupler nut. So that for threaded portion, you need to know the diameters of the nut, that is dc is equal to core diameter and d is equal to measure diameter. Okay. So by using this equation, first you have to calculate the core diameter, and the value of core diameter will be 33.21. After that, you need to consider one standard table for fixing the other values of the diameter and pitch. So by using the standard table for core series, the nearest value for this DC, as we have calculated the value of DC as 33.21, so in standard table, the nearest value for this DC will be 34.093. So select this value as a core diameter, and by using this core diameter, you can calculate the other values, that is measure diameter or nominal diameter. D is equal to 39 mm and pitch will be 4 mm. And once you get the value of pitch, you can calculate N, that is number of threads per mm length, by using equation 1 upon P. So N will be 1.25 mm. Okay. Second step is length of the coupler nut. So here the equation of length of coupler nut is tau is equal to PD upon pi DC multiplied by L. So from this equation, the length of the coupler nut, that is small m, is calculated. So the value of L will be 16.18 mm. But from empirical relation, L is equal to diameter of the each rod, that is L is equal to D. So D is nothing but 39 mm. So if you compare these two values of L, that is 16.18 and 39 mm, the largest value is 39 mm. So always select the largest value for the dimension. As the dimension will be large, your area, the resisting area will be large, and the induced stresses will be less. So always select the larger value for the dimension. So select the value of L as 39 mm. Okay. Next step is check the induced crushing stress when you have select the values of diameter, core diameter and length as, that is length as 39 mm, diameter 39 mm and core diameter as 34.039 mm. Okay. So once you put the all these values in this equation, you will get sigma CR is equal to, that is crushing stress induced, 23.66 MPa. So compare this induced crushing stress with given permissible stress. So in problem, we have given the permissible stress as 90 MPa. So here you can see, as the induced crushing stress is less than 90 MPa, so we can say that our design is safe. Okay. Keep in mind that the induced stresses should be should always less than the permissible given stresses for the safe design. Okay. Next step is outer diameter of the coupler nut. So the equation for outer diameter of coupler nut is sigma t is equal to pd upon pi by 4 d square minus d square. So by using this equation, you can calculate the outer diameter of the coupler nut, that is d is equal to 51.22 mm. Okay, but from empirical relation, d is equal to 1.25 times d. So that value becomes 48.75 mm. Again, compare these two values of diameter, that is 51.22 mm, that is approximately equal to 52 mm, and 48.75 mm, that is approximately equal to 50 mm. So in that, the largest value will be 52 mm. So for safer design, select the diameter as 52 mm. Okay. Next is outer or outside diameter of the coupler. So from this equation, you can calculate the value of D2, that is outside diameter of the coupler. So the equation for outside diameter of the coupler is sigma t is equal to pd upon pi by 4 d2 square minus d1 square. So here the value of d1 will be taken from the empirical relation, that is d1 is equal to d plus 6 mm, and the value will be 45 mm. So put this value in above equation. So from this equation, you will get the d2 as 55.93, but in actual practice, d2 is equal to 1.5 times d, so that value becomes 58.5 mm. So compare these two values of diameter, this value and this value, and select the larger value, that is 58.5 mm. That is so for safe design, the selected value will be 60 mm, that is this value. So here the other dimensions of the turnbuckle are set or fixed by using the empirical relations. So next step is length of the coupler nut. So L is equal to 6 times diameter, so it will become 234 mm. Thickness of the coupler, that is T, is equal to 0.75 times T, so it will become 29.25, approximately equal to 30 mm. And the last step is thickness of the coupler nut, that is T1, is equal to 0.5 times diameter, so it will become 20 mm. So this is all about the example of turnbuckle. If you have any doubt or query, you can always contact me. Thank you.